Are you thinking of hosting a webinar for your customers, prospects, or community, but don't want to pay for a webinar platform? In today's video, you'll learn how to set up and run your next webinar for free using AWeber, a free live streaming service like Streamyard or Restream, and YouTube. Streamyard and Restream are live streaming services that allow you to broadcast to your social media channels from an easy-to-use web interface. You can share your webcam, slide presentations, videos, text on your screen, or even have a guest on with you. Both Streamyard and Restream offer free versions of their software that allow you to broadcast to a single location, whether it's YouTube, Facebook, or any other social media platform. Plus, when you run your webinars through live streams, you get the added bonus of growing your social media audience and boosting engagement on your social media channels. But how do you get your registrant's information if all you're doing is live streaming to YouTube? That's where AWeber comes in. Let's dive in and I'll show you how to set up your webinar with AWeber and YouTube. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna schedule our live stream with your preferred live streaming service of choice. In this example, I'm gonna be using Streamyard and I'm gonna be broadcasting to YouTube. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna create a broadcast. We'll select our YouTube channel. And then we'll add a title, and this will be the name of our webinar. This is going to be a cooking webinar, so let's go ahead and grab our title, paste it into the title area. And then for the description, I'm going to use sort of a general statement about what you're going to get out of this webinar, as well as the date and time. Next, I'm going to set my privacy to unlisted because I don't want my webinar being discovered on YouTube without people having to register for it. You're more than welcome to change the privacy after the fact, but you can keep it unlisted so people can't discover it before signing up for it. Next, I'm going to check the schedule later button or checkbox, and this gives me the option to upload a thumbnail image as well as pick a date and time. So let's go ahead and upload a thumbnail image that I have already created. And you can use Canva or Photoshop to create a thumbnail image very quickly and easily. Next up, let's go ahead and pick the date and time of our webinar. So this one is going to be on the 2nd of November at 1 p.m. Eastern time. When I'm all finished, I'll click on Create Broadcast. And my live stream has been scheduled on my YouTube channel. Now what I'm going to do is on the right hand side, you'll see three little dots. If you click on that, you'll go view on YouTube and you'll find your scheduled live stream on YouTube. You can grab the URL for that. We're going to be using that in the next step, which is creating our registration page and thank you page in AWeber. So let's head on over to AWeber. And from here, we're going to go to our landing pages. We're going to create a registration page using AWeber's landing page builder to collect names, email addresses, and any other information you'd like to collect from your registrants. If you're not using AWeber, you can create a free account and create as many landing pages and automated campaigns as you'd like. Simply click the link in the description to sign up for free. Now back to our registration page. I've gone ahead and I've created a registration page already, but what I want to do is jump in here real quick and show you a few things that are important to set up when you're running a webinar using AWeber. First up, we've got our copy already set up here and our form. One thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the form and under the submissions tab on the right, I'm going to apply a tag when someone signs up. So in this case, it's going to be a cooking webinar. So we're going to put in cooking webinar. And when people sign up through this form, they're going to be tagged with cooking webinar. And that's important for the next step, which I'll get to in just a moment. The next thing I want to do is I have a thank you page and already subscribe page option here. Right now it's going to a simple automatically generated thank you page that we have in AWeber. But what we want to do is we want to use a custom URL here. So let's go ahead and jump out of this, save and exit. And we're going to head on over to our thank you page first. Let's go ahead and click on thank you page. Now this has also been already created. But what we're going to do here is on the button where it says watch the live stream, it's going to go ahead and click on that. And on the right here, we're going to paste in the URL for our live stream that we just copied and pasted from YouTube. Then we're going to go ahead and save and exit. and we're going to publish our thank you page. You'll notice that the link for the thank you page is right here below. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy that to my clipboard and come back to my registration page. I'm going to go down and click on the form again and head over to our submissions tab, where we're going to use a custom URL for our thank you page. We're going to paste in the link for our thank you page that we just copied. Same thing for the already subscribed page, in case someone subscribes and then forgets that they subscribed and tries to do it again. You want to get them to the thank you page. So now that's been customized so that when they sign up through this form, they're A, going to be tagged with cooking webinar, and B, they're going to arrive on our custom thank you page where they can click the link to join the live stream. So I'm gonna go ahead and save and exit from here. And the last step is to publish our registration page. There we go, it's now been published. So both our registration page and our thank you page are now live, and we can begin sharing those on social media and other places. The next step is to create an automated email that goes out to those who sign up with the link for the live stream. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over to our messages and go to campaigns, and we're going to create an automated campaign for our cooking webinar. Go ahead and click on create a blank campaign. We'll call this our cooking webinar campaign. Click on create. And then we're going to begin this campaign on a tag rather than sending it to all of our new subscribers. So click on tag applied. And the tag that we used on the landing page, we're going to enter in here. So cooking webinar. So when someone signs up on that registration page, they'll get tagged with cooking webinar and they'll begin receiving this campaign. The next step is to start building this campaign. So let's go ahead and put a message in here as our first action. And I've already written a message for our welcome email. So I'm going to go ahead and click on choose a message. And there's our message. You're in. Thanks for registering for my free cooking webinar. Click on select. And now it's ready to go. Now, if you didn't create your message ahead of time, that's totally fine. You can also create one right from the campaign builder. If I go ahead and put a new message in here, I'll show you what I mean. If you click on create a message and go to our drag and drop email builder, that's where you'll be able to create your message. And once you're finished, it will bring you right back to your campaign here to finish up. I'm gonna go ahead and remove that for now. And let's go ahead and preview this message. So this message has all the same information that was on the thank you page with a link to the live stream. Since we haven't put that in there yet, we need to click on that, open this message up, and paste in that YouTube link. Let's go ahead and grab it one more time. Come down here to the button. We will paste that into the URL there, and now it has been linked up to our YouTube live stream. So go ahead and save and exit, which will take us back into our campaign. And it looks pretty good, it's ready to go. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and save and exit. And the last step here is to activate our campaign. So on the drafts dropdown, we'll click on activate campaign. And now it is active. So when someone signs up on your registration page, they're going to arrive on your thank you page, and they're going to get an automated email right away that says, thanks for subscribing. Here's the link to join the live stream. The next step we want to do is we want to be able to send our registrants a reminder either the day of, or maybe even, you know, a few minutes before it begins, to make sure that they come and join. So what we'll do is we're going to go to our subscriber management area, and we're going to create a segment or a subgroup of subscribers who have the tag cooking webinar. So under the search options, we're going to click on tag and then enter our tag on the right here. So we'll say cooking webinar, click on search. There won't be anyone in this segment yet, but don't worry, as people sign up, they'll automatically be added to the segment. So what we'll do is we'll name this our cooking webinar registrants, hit save, and that segment has now been saved, and you'll find that over here on the left for your cooking webinar registrants. And again, like I said, this is a dynamic segment, so as people sign up and get tagged with cooking webinar, they will automatically be added to this segment. So from here, what we can do is we can schedule our broadcast reminder to go to this audience the morning of our webinar. So we can come over to our messages, go to our drafts, and I've already written a reminder email. So we'll go ahead and schedule that right now. So here it is. Don't forget, cooking webinar today at 1 p.m. To do that, we're going to click on send options, go to schedule a broadcast. Where it says who should receive this message, we're going to change that from all active subscribers to, you guessed it, our cooking webinar registrants. Click on apply, and then we can go ahead and we can pick when we want to send this. Since this webinar is on the 2nd at 1 p.m., we'll go ahead and schedule it on the 2nd in the morning at 9 a.m. to remind them that that day is the webinar. Click on apply, and then we can go ahead and hit schedule message. Now that message has been scheduled, it's put into our scheduled message queue, and we'll go out on the 2nd at 9 a.m. to our cooking webinar registrants. And as people begin to join the landing page, they'll automatically be added to that segment of registrants. When you're ready to go live on the day of your webinar, you'll go ahead and start your live stream in StreamYard or in Restream if you're using Restream. So what you'll do here is you'll enter your broadcast studio, you'll hit go live, and you'll begin giving your presentation. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about how to use StreamYard. There's plenty of tutorial videos around the web, so definitely go check those out. But that's how you would do your webinar through StreamYard. After the webinar, you'll want to do a few things to your landing page, your campaigns, and you know, also to send out a replay link to those who registered for your webinar. So let's head back over to AWeber real quick. We'll show you I'll show you where to go to do that. So let's go over to our landing pages first. So the webinar is already done. Let's just assume we're fast forwarding to November 2nd at 2 p.m. Our webinar is done and we're ready to make some updates to our registration page and so on. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna edit our registration page. And we're going to remove any mention of the date. So let's go ahead and remove this date right here. And time. So all it says is join me for a 1-hour live training. We'll remove the word live and we're going to put on demand because this is no longer live. And what we'll do here is Well, that's all set. So now people can still register for this on-demand version of your webinar and then get to the recording of it. So you're still able to use this to collect subscribers and to build an email list. Let's go ahead and save and exit. And we'll go ahead and hit publish. So now those changes have been published. And the next thing we want to do is on our thank you page, let's go ahead and go over there. We'll make some edits here as well. So we're going to also remove our reference to the date and time. And then what you can do is you can continue to link people off to this YouTube video, but you can also use our smart content element to embed that video right onto this page. So it gives them one less thing they have to do. Let's go ahead and drag that smart content element in here and we'll go ahead and grab our YouTube link and paste it right here and it will automatically add and embed that playable video right here on our page. And I can go ahead and I can remove this button now. And now it's all set. So if I go ahead and save and exit, and then publish my changes, we're all done. All right, so now that our registration page and our thank you page have been updated to be more of an on-demand training, directing them to the replay of the webinar. Next up, we need to go to our campaign and also update our welcome email. Because as people sign up on the registration page for the on-demand version, we want to make sure that that message is representing it correctly. So let's go ahead and click on our message here and open it up. And then we'll also remove any reference to the date and time of this webinar. Let's go ahead and remove that. You don't have to do anything with the link here. It's still directing to YouTube where they can watch that. If you want to, you can also change this to your landing page. where they can watch it embedded. And that's a beneficial thing because then you can put other stuff on that landing page. If you want to introduce them to your products or your services, you can also direct them there. Whereas sending them directly to YouTube, you don't really have a whole lot of control over that environment. So you can do it either way. So now that I've updated my registration page and my campaign, my thank you page, now what I want to do is I want to send a recording, a replay email to those who registered. So what I can do at this point is come over to my drafts under messages. And then I already have a replay email set up. So what I can do is I can schedule this broadcast. And again, we're going to send it to our segment of people who registered for the webinar. So there it is, cooking webinar registrants, click apply. And then we'll go ahead and schedule this for the second, maybe in the evening. Let's just pick 5 p.m. There we go. Go ahead and click apply. Now that's been scheduled for November 2nd at 5 p.m. So well past our webinar time. And that gives your webinar registrants another point where they can come and watch the replay. You can introduce them to your products and services and so on. Go ahead and hit schedule this message. And now that's also been added to our scheduled message queue. And the great thing about this is you can do all this ahead of time so that you don't have to worry about doing that all afterwards. So, all right, let's go ahead and head back over here. All right, that's it. If you have any questions, go ahead and put them in the comments. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell to get notified of new videos. Thanks for watching.